John and Dake and Alira X split system with advanced streamer technology to remove more than 99% of harmful indoor air pollutants and surround yourself with cleaner air this summer. Dakin, perfecting the air.
Hello again. Late autumn days don't come much better than today. After a frosty start, dipping to 5 degrees, the city peaked at 20. It's been 6 years since we had a 20-degree day this late in May. The clear skies and calm conditions also delivered a very chilly morning. Coldstream had its coldest morning of the year, falling to minus 2, the second morning in a row that it's dropped below zero. Avalon only just stayed above, with a low of 1 degree. Rosebud got down to 2, Werribee and Epping 3, but daytime temperatures have been well above our May average. Werribee warmed up to 21, Epping reached 20, and Geelong also peaked at 20 after an overnight low of 5. Northern Victoria was under a frost warning this morning, and most locations dipped below zero. But just like Melbourne, daytime temperatures have been in the high teens and the low 20s. Mildura has been the warmest spot in the state, 22 degrees, but Horsham rebounded from minus 1 to reach 21. A high pressure system is sitting right above us today, and it's been keeping most of the country dry for the past week. Won't move much tomorrow, so we can expect similar conditions, but a front will move into the southwest of the country, and that will signal the beginning of a wet week. The system will track eastwards on Wednesday, and on Thursday we're expecting to see a northwest cloud band develop. These tend to bring consistent soaking rain, and the combination of those two systems is likely to deliver rain to 70 to 80% of the country over the coming week. Tomorrow, Perth is forecast to have its coldest day of the year so far, with a top of 20, also up to 25 millimetres of rain. Another sunny day for Adelaide, 23, a shower or two for Hobart and a top of 16. Canberra is heading down to minus 1 before warming up to 18. Sydney should reach 22 under sunny skies and 24 for Brisbane. Back home, northern districts once again under a frost warning. Most areas are forecast to drop to 0 or 1 degree, down to minus 1 at Echuca and Shepparton. Then tomorrow it'll be another calm and sunny day statewide, with maximums in the low 20s through the west and also much of the south. Winds will pick up a little around Melbourne tonight, so it won't get quite so cold. Minimums of 7, 8 and 9 degrees through the south, and the eastern suburbs generally 6 or 7 degrees elsewhere, a low of 5 at Coldstream. Then western suburbs are expected to reach 20 or 21, mostly 19 degrees through the east. For Geelong, a low of 7, then a sunny top of 21. The city is forecast to drop to 9 degrees, then it's expected to reach 19. Sunny again on Wednesday, but it will become windy in the afternoon, a top of 18 degrees. Then winds will continue to strengthen overnight into Thursday, a top of 21. The cloud will increase before showers arrive in the afternoon. At this stage, 2 to 10 millimetres. We could get another 10 on Friday morning, a top of 17 degrees. Just 13 with possible showers over both days of the weekend, and 15 with breaks of sunshine on Monday. So we'll have to make the most of the next few days. Tonight, down to 9 degrees, then a sunny day with a top of 19. We will certainly notice winter's arrival on Saturday.
We had a good run, but it's turning quickly.